I hope you you attended last night's dinner, because last night's dinner was, the entertainment at the dinner was a typical example of cultural heritage. We saw the people playing music and dancing, and it was very clear that these people had been practicing things that they learned from their ancestors, from their parents, from their grandparents. And so I'm going to talk a little bit about cultural heritage. I will start with giving a little bit my personal life to start before I met with computers to show why I'm concerned with cultural heritage in the first place. So after I extended my primary school, my parents in our house got a really interesting device, this telephone. I remember the telephone was installed in my house, and this allowed us to communicate with people and to actually dial different people, so connect. And then I started to play music actually very early on, and this is literally the old violin, the very small children's violin that I started when I was 6 years old. And the violin itself, I found out later on, is built about 1800. So the violin itself is now over 200 years old. I still cherish this one. And my very old music teacher actually gave me several old instruments to practice, a flute, a clarinet, the violin, and so on. And then I got interested in musical cultural heritage. And actually, I've been doing some professional work in that field. This is a picture. To the left, you see the picture of an Italian small harpsichord built around 1640. In its state as it arrived, and at the right-hand side you see that now there's a lid inside. The lid is built by me and painted by me to match the painting. So I'm educated, so my real education is not computer science, my real education is restoration of historic musical instruments. That's fine. And then when I was a young guy, I found out about the history of music and, for instance, about Mozart. And one of the interesting things that I know about Mozart is Mozart didn't only write music and make jokes, but he actually devised an interactive piece of music. So this is a part of the score Mozart wrote down, and this score should be used with a dice. You throw a dice, and based on the dice and based on some funny names that Mozart used for his family, you could compose a piece of music. So this is the translation of these scribbles, and this is an example of a menuet completely based on Mozart's score, but with the help of an interactive device, a dice. Okay, and then I found out that not only Mozart did this one, but Hiller did the same one in 1959, and I remember I bought the book immediately, and Hiller composed a string quartet based on a random numbers generator. He spent the whole chapter in his book to create a